Chapter 2 of Aule and Yavanna. Aule is the one who makes the dwarves. Yeah, he creates what are known as the Seven Fathers. And he makes them because he's impatient about the coming of the children of Ilúvatar, and he wants followers to teach all of his lore and skills to. But Ilúvatar sees this and says to him, you know, you can't really give them sentience, right? Meaning you can't give them the secret fire. Only I can. So they would basically be like little automatons. Is that what you wanted? And Aule feels really guilty and says, oh, no, I just wanted beings to love and to teach and to show the beauty of the world to. Not to make a mockery out of creation. I just wanted to create because that's the nature you gave me. Let me offer these creatures to you so you can do what you want with them. And then he says that maybe he should just destroy them. Like, Aule goes from feeling really guilty to, here are the dwarves, okay, or maybe I'll just destroy them, I'm so sorry. And just as he's about to smash the dwarves with a hammer, crying as he's doing it, Ilúvatar says, okay, no, don't do that. I accept your offer. Bam, they have souls now, so don't kill them. So even though Aule and... This is interesting because even though Aule and Melkor are similar in skill, as I've mentioned before, can you see Melkor being humble like this? I don't think so. Melkor would never feel guilty like Aule did. And another thing to note, this little vignette, it kind of reminds me of the biblical story of Abraham, like being willing to sacrifice his son Isaac to God, and then God stops him right before he does it. It sounds like that might have been an inspiration to Tolkien, because remember, he was a devout Catholic. So the dwarves are allowed to live, but Ilúvatar tells Aule that he has to put them to sleep for now, because they can't be awake before the coming of the firstborn, which are the elves. And then Ilúvatar makes a prediction. But when the time comes, I will awaken them, and they shall be to thee as children, and often strife shall arise between thine and mine, the children of my adoption and the children of my choice. So this kind of explains that elves and dwarves are not always going to be the best of friends, which is something that we will come to see. We will see this come into play later on in the book. Dwarves live longer than men, but they're not immortal. And they believe that when they die, their souls go to a special section of the Halls of Mandos. And after the end of the world, they will help Aule to rebuild it. They also believe that the Seven Fathers periodically reincarnate and take their old names again. So you might see the name Durin show up again and again and again. So that's where that belief comes from. So after Aule puts the dwarves to sleep in far off different places, he puts the Seven Fathers to sleep in far-flung corners of the world, he tells his wife Yavanna about them. And she gets worried that when they wake up, they'll just start chopping down her trees willy-nilly. And he tells her that the children of Ilúvatar will also chop down trees for their own uses. So, you know, what's the big deal? And this upsets her so much that she goes to Manwë and says, is this true? Are the children of Ilúvatar gonna chop down all my plants? And Manwë's like, yeah, what's your point? And she says that because Melkor has messed up so many of her creations, it's a bummer that the children are going to do the same. And at least the animals can run away or defend themselves, but the plants can't. If only the trees could speak on behalf of all plants. And Manwë's like, okay. But this actually, what she says here, this actually appeared in Yavanna's original music. And Manwë then has a vision from Ilúvatar. When he comes out of the vision, he tells Yavanna that once the firstborn awake, Ilúvatar will allow spirits to enter some of her creations, and they will be held in reverence, and their anger will be feared. And Manwë says that great eagles will go to Middle-earth before the children awake in order to watch over her creations as well. So she's pretty happy about this. And he also tells her that after the firstborn come to life, in the forests shall walk the shepherds of the trees. That means the Ents. So dwarves come from Aule, and the Ents come from Yavanna. Yeah, remember Treebeard from Lord of the Rings? There we go, he's a creation of Yavanna. And I love how this chapter ends. It's kind of funny. Yavanna goes and tells Aule, "Your dwarves better watch out. They better not make my trees angry." And he's like, "Yeah, but they'll still need wood." It's a funny married couple kind of arguing. It's a very cute ending to this very short chapter.